guys, welcome to today's video. So this is going to be The Ordinary series number 2, which is anti-aging, and I will be providing a morning skincare routine today. Now if you are new to my channel, I recently started a skincare series where I'm going to be sharing basic, straightforward starter routines that will target certain skin types and skin concerns only using products from The Ordinary skincare line. So I've already uploaded series 1, which was dry skin, and I will leave those two videos below for you. And today is anti-aging. So let's get right into it. But before we do, if you could please like this video, subscribe, and ring that notification bell. By doing so, you will always be notified whenever I upload a new video, and I do upload videos every single week. So if you are new to my channel, I have normal to combination skin. I am prone to hormonal breakouts, which typically happens on my cheeks, my chin, my jawline, and going down my neck. I do have redness. A lot of it is natural, but some of it is caused by acne that I had in the past. For example, this spot right here. So now I'm left with post-acne marks that I'm trying to lighten and fade with certain skincare products. So that is my skin type for reference. So anti-aging, that is what we're going to be talking about today, and I'm going to be sharing a morning routine. Now this routine can be used by anybody. So you can be in your early 20s all the way up to your 90s and still use this. Now this routine will help with a brighter complexion. This will also help to target any hyperpigmentation, fine lines and wrinkles, and it's a great routine for prevention as well. So let's get right into it. So I already cleansed my skin with the squalene cleanser, but when it comes to the morning routine, you don't necessarily have to use a cleanser to remove anything off your skin. Your skin is already clean from the night before, but for me personally, I do like to cleanse my skin to freshen up my face, because depending on what I'm using the night before, like an overnight mask or whatever the case may be, I do like to cleanse my skin in the morning. And that's just something that I've always done. If you have sensitive, really dry skin, you may want to skip the cleansing step and just rinse your face off with water, towel dry it, and then of course go in with your skincare products. So I've already used this. So I just went to dampen my skin because the first serum that we're going to be going in with is the hyaluronic acid 2% plus B5. Now this is a great serum to incorporate not only for hydration, but this is great for anti-aging as well, because this product will give you a plumper look to your skin. And this will give you an instant quick fix, which is temporary, but it will instantly plump up those fine lines. So I always recommend hyaluronic acid. So I'm going to apply at least 5 to 6 drops to my face. Let's do 6. And of course, this is going to be going on the neck as well. I do go underneath my eyes with this as well. And then once it's all distributed, I like to pat it in. All right, next product. So now I'm going to apply a vitamin C serum. Now from The Ordinary, they have a lot of options to choose from. So if you have your favorite, you can use it. I really enjoy the ascorbic acid 8% plus alpha arbutin 2%, because alpha arbutin is a skin brightener. So this will help to lighten and brighten any hyperpigmentation that you may have, like post-acne marks. And not only is the vitamin C going to help with the same thing, but so is the alpha arbutin. So I feel like I'm getting a double dose of that skin brightener in this formulation. So I really enjoy this one. Now I like to apply my vitamin C's to damp skin. So after I've applied the hyaluronic acid, I like to keep my skin tacky and damp, and then I like to go in with my vitamin C, whether it's from The Ordinary or from a different brand. Now, if your skin is more on the sensitive side, or you're prone to being sensitive to vitamin C products, then apply them to dry skin to prevent that quick absorption. So, do what works for you. So I'm going to apply 4 to 5 drops. And I'm not going to be applying this to under my eyes, because I have another product that I'm going to apply under there instead. So I just pat this all over. I do find that this absorbs into the skin pretty quickly, but I do feel like it's more on the oily side. It is oil-free, but it just has that texture to it. But it does sit really nice underneath sunscreen and makeup. Now, since the vitamin C that I used has more of an oily texture to it, even though it's oil-free, I'm going to allow it to absorb into my skin a little bit longer before applying the next product. So while I'm waiting for that to absorb, I am going to apply the Ordinary Argireline Solution 10%. Now, this is a peptide and it's great for anti-aging, perfect for fine lines and wrinkles, for crow's feet, for your 11s, your forehead lines, your nasolabial folds, or you can apply this to your entire face and your neck if you want to. But when it comes to peptides like this one, you don't want to be using them with your vitamin C's, specifically pure forms of vitamin C's like ascorbic acid or L-ascorbic acid, because they conflict and they could cancel each other out. And not only that, some people could experience irritation with this pairing as well. So if you're not sure what type of vitamin C you have, don't use it with your peptides, just to be sure. So because I did not apply vitamin C to my under eyes, I'm going to apply this to that area. Now, if you're someone that can't use vitamin C because maybe you're allergic to it and you're very sensitive, then you could use your peptides in the morning as part of your anti-aging routine. So you could do that as well. So I'm going to apply this, and all you need is one drop. And a little bit goes a long way because this serum is honestly like water. And I just tap it around the eye area. Sometimes I will apply it under my brow bone, which I will today, but I can't do it on an everyday basis because I do find that it can dry my eyelids out. So you do need to be careful with this serum. You may not experience that, but I do from time to time. And then I just pat it in until it's all absorbed in. All right, so now I'm gonna go in with the resveratrol 3% plus ferulic acid 3%, which is an antioxidant. And this is great for fine lines and wrinkles and for anti-aging. And I use this every single morning with my vitamin C, whether I'm using the one from The Ordinary or a different brand. This truly has been a staple in my skincare routine and I love it. So I highly recommend. So I'm going to apply two drops for my face. And I do find that's all you really need for your face, maybe three, because it does have an oily texture to it and it does spread very nice. And I pat this into my skin. So I do two drops for my face and I will do 1 to 2 drops for my neck separately. But of course, you can apply 4 drops at once and apply all over if you really wanted to speed up the process. But I do like to take my time when it comes to my morning routine. Especially if I have time in the morning. If I don't have time in the morning, 4 drops, all over, done. So I will do 1 drop for my neck. That's typically what I do. And just distribute it everywhere, pat it in. And this is a serum that does take a little bit to absorb into the skin because of that texture. It is oil-free, but I don't know, it just has that texture to it. It's a nice texture. I feel like it's very hydrating and it feels amazing on the skin. And I never have issues with this product pilling with my sunscreen ever. So I always recommend this serum to those that are looking for an anti-aging serum, specifically an antioxidant. So now I'm going to apply the Natural Moisturizing Factors plus Hyaluronic Acid, which is the moisturizer. And I'm going to apply that all over my face and my neck. And I do go underneath my eyes with this and under my brow bone. And that is it. So now, sunscreen. So from The Ordinary, they have the Mineral UV Filters SPF 30 with antioxidants. I am not going to be using this sunscreen in today's video, and the remaining morning routines during this series, I will not be using this. If you want to see what it looks like, I did apply this in my series 1 for dry skin in that morning routine, which I will leave below for you. You will see why I don't like it. There's many reasons. I do have a love-hate relationship with this, but there's more cons than pro. The only pro to this sunscreen is that if you are somebody that wears makeup, this sits very nice under makeup and it keeps your makeup looking radiant and fresh all day long. Your makeup stays in place, it acts as a primer, and it looks beautiful. But if you're somebody that does not wear makeup, your skin will have a white, purple, maybe a gray tone to the skin, depending on what skin tone you have, and it will be noticeable all day long. And it takes a long time to massage this into the skin and to make it blend and have it absorb into the skin where it looks half decent, where you could go out in public without people looking at you like, what is wrong with you? It's just one of those sunscreens where it's difficult to use and it takes a long time to absorb into the skin. So I really wouldn't recommend this unless you wear makeup every day. And if this is a sunscreen that you truly love and that you enjoy, then continue using it. So I am not going to use that today. So the sunscreen that I will be using today is by Paula's Choice, and it's the Super Light Daily Wrinkle Defense Broad Spectrum SPF 30. This one also has resveratrol in it, which is that antioxidant, perfect for anti-aging. And that's why I really wanted to feature this sunscreen in particular in this anti-aging video. So this is a sunscreen that I recently picked up. I really enjoy it. I will be uploading a sunscreen video very soon, this month actually, so get ready. I will be featuring all of my go-to sunscreens. But this one is a silky lotion that has a natural tint to it, and this is supposed to mattify your skin. But this does not mattify your skin where your skin looks super matte, because I don't like that look on myself, and this actually keeps your skin looking skin-like without you looking too oily or too matte. So it's that nice in between, if that makes sense. So I'm going to apply this one today, and I am going to apply the two-finger rule where you grab your index finger and your middle finger like that and apply a thick line from the base to the tip of the finger. And this is the amount that you want to apply to your skin to get the full UV protection of that SPF 30. And this will equal out to approximately a half a teaspoon of sunscreen. So I'm going to apply this to my face and my neck, of course, my ears, underneath my eyes, my eyelids. And if I was going outside today, I'd be putting this on my chest as well, but I am not. It's currently raining, so I am not going outside. Now, this one does not leave a white cast on myself. It does have that slight tint to it, but this actually settles down beautiful on this skin. Now, if you have darker skin than I do, it's possible that you could see a white cast to your skin. But this is actually one of the nicer mineral sunscreens that I've used where you don't have a white cast. And you could go out in public without wearing makeup. And I like sunscreens like this because I don't always want to wear makeup. But I also don't want to look like Casper every time I go out in public either. So it's nice to find a sunscreen that works for you. So I think this is all massaged in. Get more on my earlobes, tips of my ears. I need my mirror because I can't really see. Yeah, it's all massaged into my skin. So there's a slight cast to my face, but it's not crazy. And as this absorbs into my skin a little bit longer, this will tone down even more and it will look more skin-like. So I really enjoy this. So if you're into Paula's Choice and you like mineral sunscreens, I would definitely give this a go. It doesn't have that gross sunscreen smell either, and it's just a lovely option to go with. So that's what the sunscreen looks like on my face. Much better than the ordinary sunscreen, and that literally took less than 4 minutes to absorb into my skin. Whereas with the sunscreen from The Ordinary, I'm not lying, that one took about 15 minutes to massage into my skin before it absorbed fully. I actually had to fast forward that clip in that video because it took a really long time. So check out that video if you want to know what I'm talking about. This is a great option, or any other mineral sunscreen for that matter. matter. So that completes the morning anti-aging skincare routine. I really hope that you found it helpful. I will have all of the products that I used in today's video linked below for you. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on the evening routine as well as the remaining part of this series as well. So thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. And of course, I will see you all in my next video. So take care and I will see you guys then. Bye guys.